Okay, welcome, friends. Nice to see you again. So I'm going to do what I always do, which is just take you in. I invite you to join me in this. Just looking at each other's faces, names, environments. And noticing how that is internally as we do that. I don't know if it's just me, but you all look like you have a bit of a glow to you. The retreat glow, perhaps. Maybe it's just for those of us in the Northern Hemisphere. Well, it's not just the Northern Hemisphere. It's just particular. I don't know what you call it, latitudinal, longitudinal UK morning, UK Europe morning light, morning glow. It's a gorgeous morning here in London. Very sparkly. So let's just also take a minute to tune in internally and feeling free to do any resourcing that feels good to you. So for some reason, my hands want to rub the thighs. Feels good to do that. Maybe you want to do a bit of looking around, orienting, a bit of self-holding. Your self-touch, joints, maybe a bit of movement, stretching. A bit of rocking. Whatever you know helps you to arrive. Deep breaths. Connecting with the earth below and the space all around. As well as the internal landscape. Just my mail coming through the door, in case you heard that. I don't know if you did. Okay, so, and then just one more looking around. Taking each other in again. So, just bear with me. I'm going to make a couple announcements because this is our, I don't know what you call the third to last. I was going to say penultimate, but it's not the penultimate, is it? Because that's the second to last. So this is the third to last session of the retreat. And I noticed in the chat, there are a few of you saying this might be your last session. So yeah, so just want to share a few things by way of how you might be able to both begin sort of preparing yourselves for this transition off of the transition into the ending of the retreat and beyond in different ways, depending on whether or not you're able to join us for the middle and late sessions. So firstly, we will be doing in the traditional True Ratna fashion, some reporting out in small groups this afternoon. And there's a couple of questions and I'm just gonna let you know them now, I was sort of debating whether that was a good idea because then you might spend the whole meditation just like thinking about the questions. But we'll practice our compartmentalization and boundary skills here. So I'll give you the questions and then you've got them for the remainder of the time that we have with us. And when we get to the middle section, there'll be a chance. I'll also lead us in a little bit of a reflection then and a chance to share with others. And these are also on the Padlet. So Zach, actually, I don't know where's that. Oh, there you are. Maybe you could drop the link to the Padlet in the chat. So the questions are, and I'll put these in the chat as well. What do you want to remember, not forget, from our time practicing together? What do you want to remember, not forget? And what do you most appreciate about our retreat? So those are the two questions we'll be reporting out around. And again, there's a section, there's a new post in the Padlet where I've put those questions, and feel free to respond there as well. Especially if you're not able to join us, it'd be nice to hear from you on the Padlet. And then also a heads up that there will be some celebrating this evening, or sorry, in the late session, which might be early morning for some of you. Well, actually, I'm sort of highly doubting that there's anyone from New Zealand, Australia in this section, because I think it's the middle of the night there. Oh no, maybe it's not the middle of the night. No, it's late in your evening, so maybe you are here. So later in either tomorrow morning for some of us, or later in the day, there's going to be some celebrating, and there's an invitation to bring any supports like soft toys or objects that you love. And there'll be a chance to reveal those to the retreat through your camera. So I've got a couple of friends I'm going to gather from around the house and bring them with me to the celebrations. Yeah, hi, Frank. I thought you were here. Um, 4:30 a.m. Oh, yeah, okay. So I'm assuming you won't be getting up that early to join us. But you can catch up on the recordings, see what we got up to while you were deep in sleep. Maybe you'll dream of us. Okay. Just wondering if there's any other announcements I've forgotten. Just going to check with Balajit. Anything else that I've forgotten?
No, I think that's it.
Okay. And then I'm going to just invite Zach to bring himself in. He's got something he wants to say on behalf of the Buddhist Center Online.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. Lovely to be with you again this morning. I've really enjoyed doing these morning sessions with you. It's nice to see sort of familiar faces coming through every morning, all the morning sessions. I suppose I just really want to wish you a sort of steady return to your normal routines post-retreat. It can be a bit bumpy. Even when you're sort of on retreat at home, so to speak, it can sort of, you need to be sort of careful with yourself. I suppose I just really hope that what you've participated in over the last week has been beneficial for you. Obviously, it seems as though it has, given the amount of messages that have been coming in most mornings, and people being very thankful. And I've really appreciated some of the messages people have personally sent to me thanking us. It's a lot of work that goes behind these retreats, that sometimes you don't see as much of it when it's all kind of, it all looks very smooth. there is a bit of a, it does take a bit of work and can go very wrong. You certainly notice when it goes wrong. What I just want to draw your attention to is, I know that many of you have already made a donation when you signed up for this retreat. You might have already guessed what's coming. But if you feel so moved, actually, just to sort of support this work, so we can continue to put on these retreats, we'll just really encourage you, if you're in a position to, just to make a donation. I'm just going to put the link in the chat. Here we are. Any small amount just really helps. Really, it helps us. Well, partly to support teachers like Singhashri, Balajit, and Viveka to continue to put on events like this. I feel it's very important that we keep doing events like this, because we allow. It's not easy for everyone to get to physical retreat centers, and it does seem as though we occupy an increasingly important aspect of Tree Ratna. So if you do want to help support that work, if you are in a position to, then I would just encourage you to give if you can. But of course, the most important thing is really that you just come along, you know, that we keep these things coming along. That's the most important thing. Just you bringing your energy and bringing yourselves contributes to what we're all experiencing here over the last week. But yeah, that'll probably be more than enough from me. But yeah, as I say, just it's been really nice to do these morning sessions with you. I'm also back here in the afternoon, so I might see some of you again. But yeah, thank you for coming. And yeah, that's probably enough.
Thank you so much, Zach. And yeah, we're going to have a chance to rejoice more fully in the team later today as well. So I won't say more now, but there's a lot in my heart right now for you and your colleagues. So I just remembered one more thing, actually. So it's good to have that moment to pause and hand over to you just for a moment to gather myself. So the other thing was that this afternoon, there'll also be an opportunity to ask any clarifying questions of myself, Balajit, or Viveka. So these are questions, clarifying questions about anything that's been taught or offered on this retreat. So a chance to, I just have to say from someone who does a lot of teaching, it's always, it's very, very important to me that it's as clear as possible. In fact, I think that's the last question the Buddha asked the assembly right before he died. Is there anything else before I go? Just to make sure there's no confusion about all of what I've given you. So I can resonate with that. I'm not claiming to be a Buddha, but I can resonate with that sentiment. Because who knows? We just don't know what's going to happen. We may never meet again. So it's good to make sure that things have been as clear as they possibly could be. Without also, there's a big both end in there, because also we don't want to privilege clarity too much. Sometimes it's good to be confused as well. but yeah, for the purposes of this retreat and what's been offered here, any clarifying questions, we'd love to hear from you, and we'll do our best to respond. Okay, so I think that's enough talking for now. This morning, we thought we would not give any more input because we've given a lot, and we just want to give you a space to have a play with all the tools and all the toys in the sandbox, as it were. So we'll do, I'll just be ringing bells for the Mettā Bhavana in this first half, and we'll have we've got time now for a 30-minute sit. So go ahead and get yourself set up for that. And of course, lying down is always an option. And I thought we could start with a poem. There's a lot of references to the body being, and this life, this being, being like a house in the suttas. The Buddha uses the metaphor of a house many times. And I thought of that when I came across this poem. So this is called The Work of Happiness, The Work of Happiness, which is pretty much the work we've been doing. All week together, we've been doing the work of happiness. And this poem is by May Sarton. It's a poet I've never heard of, and I don't know anything about. This just came across my Facebook feed. So I'll have to do a bit more research. And I'll also put it on the Padlet so you can have it if you like it. I thought of happiness, how it is woven out of the silence in the empty house each day, and how it is not sudden and it is not given, but is creation itself, like the growth of a tree. No one has seen it happen, but inside the bark, another circle is growing in the expanding ring. No one has heard the root go deeper in the dark, but the tree is lifted by this inward work, and its plumes shine, and its leaves are glittering. So happiness is woven out of the peace of hours and strikes its roots deep in the house alone, the old chest in the corner, cool waxed floors, white curtains softly and continually blown. As the free air moves quietly about the room, a shelf of books, a table, and the whitewashed wall. These are the dear, familiar gods of home. And here the work of faith can best be done. The growing tree is green and musical. For what is happiness but growth in peace, the timeless sense of time? When furniture has stood a lifespan in a single place. And as the air moves, so the old dreams stir, the shining leaves of present happiness. No one has heard thought or listened to a mind, but where people have lived in inwardness, the air is charged with blessing and does bless. Windows look out on mountains, and the walls are kind. The Mettā Bhavana practice, cultivation of loving kindness. So we'll have a 15-minute break until 5 past the hour.
So welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. So, so some people are, this will be their last time with us in this session one. So, just want to wish the people who are leaving our fellowship today, wishing you well as your practice unfolds, and hopefully see you again. If you did want to share any comments about the retreat, then do feel free to just freely post on the Padlet link, as other people I see are doing. So go well. So we're going to be a little more active before the start of this. I'm going to guide us in some some non-strenuous, non-demanding, low-risk, mindful movement, and then we'll have a very short reading, and then we'll pipe through the Shakyamuni mantra. So we'll have an opportunity to chant a mantra together, and then I'll just mark the stages of the mindfulness of breathing. So I'll ring the bell for the mindfulness of breathing, and then after the final bell of the mindfulness of breathing, I'll recite the verses to the transfer of merit and self-surrender. So transferring the merits and fruits of all our practice for the benefit of all sentient beings throughout limitless space. And Gita will be the voice of the retreat for that, as she was yesterday. So that's the rough plan. So feel free to some of these movements you can, well, all of these movements you can do sitting down, at least to some extent. So please feel free to join me in standing up. So I'm just going to rearrange my room a bit, and then we'll start. Good. So hopefully you can all see me here. So let's start by just kind of twiddling the fingers. So this is a little exercise just to bring movement. Not surprisingly, it's quite obvious, isn't it, into the finger joints. And then just a gentle rotation of the wrists. And with all these exercises, I'm kind of sensing what pace feels most interesting or most aligned for me this morning. So do feel free to have your own kind of pace. And then from there, let's just kind of do some gentle movement on the shoulders. So if you can put your hands into kind of little beaks like that, keeping the arms relaxed and light. So I think the Tibetan tradition has got it right when it talks about the mind actually travels through the channels of the body, the energy channels of the body. So we're literally kind of helping our mind develop more spaciousness, more luminosity, opening to these qualities. As we move here, freeing up restrictions and tightness and limitations in the mind through work in the joints. Very, very simple. And then we'll just complete this. So this is a movement that I've learned from Viveka, which I really like. So this is more energizing often, and it's a little bit more yang, a bit more energetic. So just sense within your range here what feels appropriate for you. And hopefully this sound will come through. Okay, so this is a zack. Ha, 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 ha. So I just turn sideways. Ha, 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 ha. Ha, 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 ha. So there's a slight variation on this, and this is to bring more of a sense of personal space and boundary. So it's what us as mammals, when we're all connected and online, would do naturally. So I'm going to turn sideways here just to show this is a bit more of a forward movement to it. So this is a ha. Ha, 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 ha. So just doing a few more of these. And then standing and sensing. And feeling that connection with the ground. Noticing whether the sense of energy in your system has gone down, stayed the same, or gone up. Just sensing that energy body. And also maybe sensing if there's a sense of more energy on the left side or on the right, or whether they're both equal. So an opportunity to customize and deepen our capacity to open to this dimension of embodiment, the energy body. And then placing the hands on the hips, and then again just doing the gyration that feels best for you. With a lot of sitting, I always try and include some hip flexibility, because so much weight can get pressed on this area in a fixed posture. So just bringing some natural movement, flexibility here, allowing it to feel into some of its range of movement in a way. And then maybe going the other way. feeling the movement of your body through space. And then gradually coming back to standing. And maybe now just a little receptivity exercise here. Where do you feel centered in? Where feels your center at the moment? Does it feel belly, chest, head? Where do you feel centered in? Is it hard to say? And then from here, we'll do a little puppet movement like we did a few days ago. So finding your balance. Sometimes it can help here to have what the yogis call a dristi point, you know, like a point to focus on, because this engages the vestibular system in particular. So again, imagining that there's a string between the palm of your right hand and your left knee, and that they're interconnected. So as you move the right hand up, it lifts the left knee up with it. And as it goes down. So we just practice with the left knee at the moment. So then really seeing if you can attune the subtlety of the movement of the right hand with the subtlety of the movement of the left knee. So this is a bilateral movement. Helping coordination between the left and right side of the body that can so easily be out of tune with each other. And then from there, the invitation is to see if you can alternate. And again, in tuning into the felt sense, maybe sensing if one side feels different to the other. Finding your own pace. Maybe also your own style, you know, maybe it's slightly kind of balletic. Maybe it's more strident and confident. Maybe it's kind of slightly sleepy. So we'll just do this a couple more times. Then coming back to standing. Noticing. Sensing the energy body again, the tingling, pulsing currents, any winds of energy. And then changing lens and sensing the emotional body. Is there any emotional weather present for you now? And then there's also the lens of physicality. So we just invite you to finish just by just kind of feeling your kind of mass, the physicalness of you. Just kind of feeling the physicalness of you. Apparently, wherever we touch on the body, it sends electrical signals to a slightly different part of the brain. So just touching different surfaces of your body can be quite energizing and stimulating. Lots of sensors in the skin firing. So we're just feeling the body of emanation, the physical body, the physicalness of it. And then gradually in your own time, we'll come to our meditation posture. So this is a reading from James Lowe. Participate as presence in the unfolding of life. This beautiful, never repeated moment, resting in your unchanging nature. Let the gestures of your energy liberate others without building solidifying bridges of concept. Letting go of the delusion of enduring essences. See how each moment arises fresh from nothing. Bright gift of effulgence, sheen of the open source.
Shakyamuni Swaha Om Muni Muni Mahamuni Shakyamuni Swaha Om Muni Muni Mahamuni Shakyamuni Swaha Om Muni Muni Mahamuni Shakyamuni Swaha Om Muni Muni Shakyamuni Swaha. Om Nim Nim Mahamuni. 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 Shakyamuni Swaha. Om Nim Nim Mahamuni.
So in a minute I'll ring the gong for the end of this meditation. And we'll recite the verses of transference of merit and self-surrender. Transference of merit and self-surrender. May the merit gained. In my acting thus. Go to the alleviation.
Of the suffering of all beings.
My personality throughout my existences. My possessions. And my merit in all three ways. I give up without regard to myself. For the benefit of all beings. Just as the earth and other elements.
Are serviceable in many ways.
To the infinite number of beings. Inhabiting limitless space. So may I become that which maintains all beings, situated throughout space, so long as all have not attained to peace.